Good evening. Fiction based on fact is a bit of a quagmire in the wrong hands. But on the joyful occasions that it works with knobs on, one ends up with a book that is not only a work of art, but of the makings of a classic. The book I have beside me is by a gentleman named Steve Sem-Sandberg, a Swede, who has written a book called The Emperor of Lies. And the story concerns the formation of the Lodz ghetto in Poland in 1940, which was a colony created by the Nazis to house what amounts to a quarter of a million Jews. The story concerns the gentleman who was responsible for this particular colony, who ran it with a deep ambition to serve the Nazis, who was completely two-faced and at the same time was as crafty and as cunning as any Nazi himself. The story is extremely rich. It is populated with all sorts of characters that come and go like ships in the night. But the entire tale, which of course encompasses a quarter of a million people, has been told extremely handsomely by this gentleman. And I'd like to read to you the first paragraph of the blurb, which normally I would never do, except that it covers the bases, probably more competently than I can, and at the same time gives you a flavor of what is fact to come. In February 1940, the Nazis established what would become the second largest Jewish ghetto in the Polish city of Lodz. Its chosen leader, Mordechai Chaim Rumkowski, a 63-year-old Jewish businessman and orphanage director, who would become the elusive authoritarian power sustaining the ghetto's very existence. This is a very handsome, beefy book on a rather less handsome subject, but the fact of the matter is these events took place, and one can only imagine, and this gentleman has, what transpired. Of all the fiction set in that particular time period that has come my way in the past year or so, this one heads the pack. It's been translated so far into 20 tongues, and I think it has another 20 to go. And on that rather unfortunate but very interesting note, good night.